Welcome to Getting Started with Canvas. In this portion, we will be discussing how to use the Rich Content Editor. The Rich Content Editor does provide access to your regular formatting tools, such as bold, italic, underline, font sizes, headings, and more. It also provides you the opportunity to add an external or an internal course link, images, files, or documents, and to embed Google Docs or slides, Kaltura videos, voice threads, and more. Anything that you can't embed directly, you do have the ability to use the Embed Cloud, and it has a much more robust accessibility checker than we had with Blackboard. To use the Rich Content Editor, I'm going to go to any page, assignment, discussion board, etc. that I have. Again, this is a blank page that we created as a placeholder. I'm going to go up to the top right and choose Edit. And this section right here under my title is known as my Rich Content Editor. I have my traditional options such as Edit, View, Insert, etc. But I also have this lovely bar that gives me many more tools. I can change my font size. I can select my headings. My traditional font adjustments. Any superscripts or subscripts. But say I want to get my students directly to a page within my course. Say I give them a to-do list for the week. And the first one is read the syllabus. One really handy feature is this course link button. So I'm going to select the word syllabus, and I'm going to use this drop-down beside links and choose course links. This is going to link to anything within my course. So for example, my syllabus is on my course navigation menu. So if I go to course navigation, I can link them directly to my syllabus. It does make it much easier. Students do not have to try to go find it or we don't have to hope that they remember where it is. They link right from here. And if I open it in a new tab, I can see that it's taken me to my course syllabus page. I have the option to add external links as well in a more traditional way. Say I want it to link to a traditional site, I can link it to, you know, read this news article. And I could paste the link from wherever I got it. I also have the ability to insert an image. If you've already chosen to upload an image, say you added a picture of yourself, like a profile picture that you use frequently, I could choose it where I've already uploaded it as a user image. So for example, my profile picture, I could add it to my page. I could also upload a new one at this time. I could do the same thing with user documents. So maybe I want to add this schedule that I need students to read. I also have access to a YouTube embedder, which will let me search YouTube. But this plug icon right here is a really handy tool, and it will let me add anything in this list. So for example, if you want to embed a Google Doc, you can grab it directly from your drive by choosing Google Drive right here. You will probably see this to give you permission to access your Google Drive, and then this menu will appear. So if I wanted to embed, say, the slides for another one of our workshops, I can attach it, and it will put a copy directly in to this page for students. Now, this is a lot. I can't see everything. I do have the option down here to make this a little larger. If you use this just so you can see things more, and you notice you don't have the ability to get out, do use the escape button at the top left corner of your keyboard, and it'll take you back to the smaller section. This works. Note that it added that Google Drive option because I used it. If I don't see something I want, I can use View All. If you're embedding, say, a recording from a Zoom class that you're pulling from Kaltura, you can do that the same way. I would embed my Kaltura media, and then I could choose my video straight from here. You have the option to just hit select, or if you use the dropdown, it'll give you an option for how large you want the video to be. And that's good, again, for If you use Office 365 or VoiceThread or YouTube videos, you can find any of those in here. Again, I have some more traditional formatting options for my alignments, bulleted lists, increasing my indent, etc. If you need a table, we do recommend you use the table creator because it'll help you create a properly formatted table that also meets accessibility requirements. For the math, this square root of x will give you your equation editor. Now, you do have the traditional tools. However, if you're comfortable, hit switch view to advanced and you can paste in Latex. If you're embedding anything else that provides you with an embed code, you can use the embed cloud at the end and paste in that code. Now, note that I have this little number 2 on my small blue person right here. This is my accessibility checker. So keep your eyes on this little pop-up. It will update as you make mistakes, but do remember that it doesn't catch everything. So if I click on my accessibility checker, it's gonna give me some things that I may have made a mistake on. So for example, I just typed 1 and a closed parentheses and started typing. Canvas is smart enough to recognize that, hey, this is a list and you didn't format it as a list. If I check this box, it's gonna help me out and reformat it for me. And then I've learned something for the future. And I hit apply. The next thing it's gonna warn me about in my case is image file name should not be used as the alt text. What that means is when the screen reader gets to this picture of me, it's going to read image and it's gonna say profile.jpg. You always wanna give clear alt text for your students. Imagine what you would say aloud if you were explaining it to a student in your class. If it does not add to the content, if it's there purely for decoration, you could use the decorative image option. So for this case, I could mark it with my name or I could just mark it decorative because it's just a picture of me. If you had a pretty header at the top of your page, for example, you might mark that as decorative because it doesn't have any content. And once I click apply, I get balloons. It gives me a little visual that, hey, I did something right. Again, always, always make sure that you use that save button. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit clt.odu.edu.